Hello and welcome, vegan savages. This is not a podcast, this is a comment video, another... How did I name this format? Ask me anything, I think. And let me know down below how you would like this format in the future. I think I just switch it up. Because like here, we have so many nice locations, I could like each question go to a different location and answer there. So the background switches up, or even like while I walk on the beach. Well, not on the beach because the waves are super loud. But how I consume this kind of content, when it's just like sitting down and talking about questions, then I don't watch, then I just listen, like when I'm riding my scooter or cooking. So I think it's better to just stay in one location where the sound is better, because that is what matters more for those videos. But let me know how you like them. Maybe I do like shorter ones where I just go around more, and deeper ones where I sit down more like podcast style. I don't know, I haven't figured the ask me anything yet out. It's not like my bread and butter, like my daily vlogs. Like I know how to do them, like I found my style and I upload every single day, and these are just like, I think that's only my second one, so excuse the mess. But what am I doing here? I just answer comments because I love interacting with you guys, my vegan savages, and I get so many good questions I want to answer or just elaborate on, and I build them in my vlogs every now and then, like almost daily, but not too many, because I still want to vlog like what I do in the day and not just to ask me anything. So that's why I opened this new format, but I keep it super flexible, not like strict, like my ask me Monday every single Monday, but just like whenever I want. So give me suggestions how you want this format down below, or just like in the flow how I do it right now here in Bali, Canggu. Just popped open my Mac, got good questions, my point and shoot camera and my microphone for better sound. So that's why I have the headphones in my ears, so I can control my voice, because if I don't have it in, then I just get more excited and speak so loud and then it peaks. So I hope you don't mind, so I can regulate my voice better and you get more crisp sound. And now I do it ASMR style. Honest question, how many girls have you had sex with so far? I had 18, all of them pretty average looking, unfortunately. Now, I know that triggers a lot of people when Mike says it like this, pretty average looking, unfortunately, but I think I know what he means by saying that. I wouldn't say it like that. I think he means like not his type, because we all have a taste and type in what person, character, shape, whatever we're into. And when we have sex with the type we are the most attracted with, then that's often the best. But often we're also surprised by like a type we're not so into, and then the sex is amazing. Well, I don't know, but I'm gonna answer that question honestly, of course, as I do always. And it's actually probably, it's less than 18. I hadn't had so many girls. I had maybe, I don't know the exact number, I tried to recollect it, but I'm not quite sure. And did that count? Like, what counts as sex for me? If it's like penis goes into the vagina, that is for me sex. And I would say I'm like 15 girls. So yeah, maybe you want to share your number down below. And I don't think it's cool to have like a high number or a low number. It's just like the coolest to have like really nice sex when it feels right, when it's good. And then the number can be 1, 2, or 200, and there's no right or wrong. I don't know, just let me know, just let me know down below. Let me know if like 15 is really little, average. Like, what is average? Like, how many? I don't know. Many find their partner like super early. They only had like 1 or 2 times sex with different people, and then they found their soulmate. And others, hundreds of different people. I don't know what's like the average. I'm sure there are studies. I would say I'm average with 15. I don't know. I'm excited if someone will answer down below honestly, but I know my vegan savages are so honest as myself, so I love that. Just re-listen to the podcast with Maddie Limburner, because I think this episode is amazing, and there are two pretty cool, I think, things I noticed. First, you said you really want a person which you love and you can work together, and now you found that person, Melina. You said a quote which is now in your new song with this person: you need to smile at the mirror that it smiles back. Wait, let me recollect my lyrics. Crossroads have a million signs, which way, yeah, I can't decide. Guess it's time to leave this room, going the way that feels right. Follow bliss, enjoy the ride, excitement leads to paradise. Where I blaze my energy, more will flow back to me. Like looking in the mirror, being sad, a smile won't reflect. No, I gotta react and smile right at to get a smile right back. How about I break out, create my own environment, enlightenment according to who I am. Sitting in my room. Yes, you're so right. I think this is so cool what you reached. Sorry for my bad English. No worry, your English is actually fantastic. And someone else commented under there, so true, and many other things. He also talked about manifesting the right partner and how to find excitement in life. That's the best podcast he ever did, in my opinion. Is it so good, Maddie Limburner? That was last year in Bali. I need to re-listen to that as well. If you haven't listened to it, I link it to you up there. That was in the Happy Villa in Ubud, where Maddie and Kyle stayed. Yeah, I need to re-listen to that. And you should also check it out. And I replied to the comment about that we spend too much time living through you. Well, yes, I did live through you, but now I do the healthy things you do. I lost 13 pounds. I eat so clean now and my depression is slowly fading. So I'm proud to be spending my time watching these vlogs. Thanks so much. That is so amazing to hear. Vegan Zoo, you are amazing. And Vegan Zoo commented again here. That made me really happy. The haters hate, but they still watch every single day. And under that, he commented, I was a hater myself and now I'm a vegan savage. Funny how life works. Funny how life works sometimes. You once said you listen to a lot of podcasts. Can you do a top 5 or top 10 of your favorite podcasts? That's a great question. We're gonna elaborate on in a future Ask Me Anything or separate video or podcast or vlog, because I actually wanna write it down to give you the best podcasts I know. Like good podcasts I recommend in general. They just upload good podcasts all the time, episodes. And then certain episodes, which is just life-changing and timeless, like old episodes 2 years ago, someone appeared on a podcast and they just flowed like crazy and I got so much value out of that and listened to it many times. I will actually come back to that comment and then I'm prepared to answer that and give it justice. Yeah, sorry that I couldn't watch and comment your vlog yesterday. Mike, you never need to apologize for that. No one needs to. But thanks. I had a solo LSD trip. One of the best experiences ever. I got a vision for you. I figured that you were almost at the top business-wise. Well, I don't think so, but thanks for the compliment. And from now on, you're going to invest all your energy into Melina. I like that. And eventually she will convince you to have a child. Not too happy about that. Women are a big puzzle, but still, if it makes you happy or the world a better place, I'm happy for you. That's a funny vision you got there. And I think I'm pretty not close to business top, but thanks for the compliment and thanks for that vision. LSD trip. Yeah, I'm sure that was profound. Should I take LSD here? No, actually drugs. We said in Axel's podcast, drugs are handled here so strictly, like you don't want to have or consume any drugs here. Because if they catch you, you're gonna get into a Indonesian jail and that's the shit we wanna avoid. How toxic are you? My mom watches you too now, haha. Always ask, I need his porridge recipe. What he did today for recipe, why is he so great at making porridge? And for me, I always laugh while watching your videos. You are so very funny. Thank you so very much. Are there going to be updates to the training guide with the new push-pull routine? Definitely, but it takes a while because I just am about to finish my first mesocycle, or well, I'm not even close to finishing it. 2 more weeks to go. And then I do another one and another one, and I at least do a new training plan at least for 3 months, but rather 6 months or longer. And the upper body, lower body split I did before, I did for over 2 years, and that's how I build most of my gains, I would say. So, and that is in my training guide, that is what I focus on, and also a full body split. And that is what is for most people the best, unless you like really dedicated. But what I'm doing right now is crazy. I go to the gym daily, and out of the 7 days, I actually weightlift 6 days, 3 times push, 3 times pull, no choke. That's only for really dedicated athletes who are just mentally insane and just love the gym. But if I like it after a couple months still, and then I probably update my training guide. So stay tuned. But I keep you up to date in my vlogs. How about that? Yes, please put those tank tops in the store. Finally, the thing is, the Vegan Savage tank tops, my print on demand supplier offers, I'm not satisfied with them, and I don't wanna publish anything in the Vegan Savage store I wouldn't wear 24/7 and I wouldn't love. And that's why I only have kind of happy customers, because I only put in the store stuff I love and I wear all the time. It's so comfortable, it looks amazing, and it lasts a long time. And tanks, I haven't found a good fit yet, but if I find one, I immediately publish it. But just cut the shirts, honestly, it's so easy. easy, and it's not like that you have to cut it all the time, like after you washed it or every day or so. No, you cut it once and it's a tank top forever. So just get a shirt, cut off the sleeves. It's so easy, it takes seconds, and you have a tank for life. Well, not for life, but for years or a long time. So just do that in the meantime. I don't understand why you like it that the cleaning stuff comes every single day. It would really annoy me because I feel like they break into my privacy. Well, I actually only saw the cleaning stuff once, and it's not annoying at all because I'm just myself everywhere, and if I'm in my room enjoying my ice cream and someone is behind me making the bed, I don't care at all. Like, I still enjoy my ice cream the same and work the same and be the same comfort level. So it's just about finding your own comfort outside your comfort zone, being comfortable outside your comfort zone. You know what I did there? But yeah, they're mostly coming when we're in the gym, so I don't even notice them. It's just clean here all the time. Love it. Because of school, I wasn't able to watch your vlogs since Monday, but now I have time and can watch all the 4 vlogs in a row, and then in a few hours there will be the next vlog. Is there anything better? Franzi, Bruna, no, that's the best. Life doesn't get better than that. It's kind of unfair to see you're there in the warm Bali and me being in the cold Germany, but it motivates me so much to get this shitty Abi, which is the high school degree in German, in Germany, because then I can travel wherever the fuck, no, she didn't say that, wherever I want. And I think one of my first places will be Bali. It's, people think I work for the government here. I convinced so many people to come to Bali, and for a reason, because it's so nice here. I mean, I should have traveled more in Asian countries to really say that, but I've been to Thailand and that's it. I should travel more in Asian countries to like say that, but I watched so many videos about different places, and just the infrastructure that is currently here in Canggu is so amazing, and what they're all building, it's crazy. Like, what have changed since February? It's insane. Like, when I was in like Chiang Mai or other places in Thailand, like, I was missing good gyms. They do have high speed Wi-Fi, but like good gyms, co-working spaces, restaurants. I mean, they have that in Chiang Mai as well. But this infrastructure of Western or Australian or just like people from any first world country in quotation marks, like in the United States or someone, settling here in Canggu and opening their business, like the CrossFit boxes and the gyms you have here, they are better than European gyms often. Like, when I was in London at VegFest, the gym there was so much more shitty. Well, it was alright, the gym, but it was more shitty than the gym I train here. And like, it's an island in Asia, they need to ship it all here, and like, how does that work? The coffee shop Wi-Fi in London, that was so shitty to all the coffee shops I went to. Like, you need to sign up, and then it's like connected with Sky, and your upload speed, it's on purpose so slow. And here you don't need to sign up, like they often don't even have a password. Everyone, every single little restaurant, warung, everything has, everyone and everything, like facility has Wi-Fi, often without a password. So high speed, it's often insane. And if it has a password, just like the password is Canggu, and you don't need to sign up, and they want you email, like in Europe, that's how, you know, often, I don't know. Here it's just easy and uncomplicated, and I just love it so much. There's just a vibe here that's just, and it's so cheap. That's the big side. You live, you have such a high living quality, like you live like a king. It's truly paradise. You spend so little. That's like the best feeling, because I just hate it. Even though I make good money, I just hate it when something is overpriced and I waste money. When I go to a restaurant and I pay $40, and I'm just like, in Bali I would have paid $3 for that, and I would have $37 to donate for charity, to do whatever, something good in the world, you know? It feels like if I'm in like LA or other expensive places, it feels like I'm burning money, and I don't like that feeling. I love that feeling of living in abundance and paying fair or just super cheap prices. In Berlin, I wouldn't go to massages twice per week because it's just super pricey. It would be like, I don't know, 400-500 euros per month, probably even more. And here it's a couple of euros per massage. It's an hour long, it's amazing, and I can enjoy it without feeling bad. By the way, they are called geckos, not salamanders. Gecko, gecko. Oh, so annoying when they make it. They actually say their own name. Gecko, gecko. Go watch the podcast, the recent podcast Axel and I recorded at V-Gains podcast, and Axel made the joke and I cracked up. That was so funny. Gecko, gecko. That's a shit that's annoying, but yeah, I gladly deal with that here in Canggu, and actually kind of enjoy it. You know, it's the vibe. It's the vibe I'm talking about. It's the tropics, baby. I think we stop here 18 minutes. That's like a good time. And let me know for future suggestions how I should do that. Ask me anything, but I think I just switch it up, you know? Sometimes I move around when but I think it's better to sit down somewhere because you don't need to watch me. I mean, you can, but you can like watch me while you do something else. And then it's even better if I don't make the visual so exciting, because then you don't feel like, oh, I miss out, but I can just like prepare my meal and focus on not cutting my fingers or be in the gym and put my phone wherever and listen to this. And I can rather talk slowly and more elaborate on your questions to give them more justice. Let me know how you like this format. And also, do you like it like faster? Should I make it more snappy and funny, or just elaborate longer, like more podcast style? Like, this is a short podcast. I don't know what this is. This is Ask Me Anything. Should I now keep going, or should I just relax? I relax, I close my Mac, and I thank you so much for watching. I see you here precisely tomorrow, because I do daily vlogs. If you haven't checked out the latest daily vlog, go do so now. If you have, then you did your homework, then you're free to do whatever. You have free time now, enjoy. But tomorrow, 6 p.m., V-Gates vlog, ready for you, like every single day. Peace, eat your chickpeas.